It's empty in the valley of your heart.
It is 8 o'clock in the morning. We're starting this thing. Daniel didn't forget anything, which is a good sign. Normally that's a problem.
Everyone's here.
For you to eat, you cannibal, you meat eater.
Been climbing up this road to get up to Lake Conoswega for like a couple miles now. And we realized that it's a lot of kind of motocross dirt bike stuff with a lot of big puddles like this. This should be the hardest climb we do today. There's a sign right here that says motorcycles only beyond this point, which makes sense because this stuff is steep. We just hit a sign that said experienced riders only. Not sure if you can see, but all the way at the top there, that's mud. And obviously the GoPro isn't gonna do a great justice of what this is, but it's not rideable, that's for sure. So we're gonna walk and then hopefully it'll flatten out at the top and then we can get back on our bikes. It's an adventure, and I wouldn't say that you can go on a proper adventure without having to walk your bikes. Daniel's a little ways back there. I'm really hoping that it flattens out up here. So the good news is it's a lot flatter up here. I gotta imagine we're close to the top-ish. Daniel's over here like struggling to get up, dude.
I'm not living here right now.
Oh my gosh. There's been a good mix of like hike a bike and somewhat ride. Running 30 PSI tires though. A lot of it's like road riding.
We're sliding everywhere.
Sliding everywhere, but I don't know. According to the Garmin, we're really close. The lake is like right there, so we're good. But yeah, we still got a little ways to go. But man, it's pretty crazy out here. A little update, we're at the top here. We finally made it. There's the gravel road that goes along right there. But as we got up, Daniel realized that he didn't know where his glasses were. So I told him to just drop the bikes and he just went back to go try and find them. Meanwhile, I'm trying to figure out how we get to the lake right there. Cause the route, it like goes right by the lake, but we have to actually go to it in order to fill up water. So, all right, so we took a little detour. We finally got out of it. We made it to Lake Conoswega. Looking for water fountains, we didn't find any. So we're probably just gonna keep going and filter the water somewhere. But
I'm sad.
He lost his glasses.
Don't worry, the monetization on this YouTube video will buy it for me.
We're standing on a dock that is very, very slippery. Oh my gosh. All right, we're gonna go get back on the main route and keep going. All right, we made it to the Mill Creek Overlook, and yeah, the weather's pretty nice. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the Tennessee-Georgia border is right up there, so we're getting there.
Time, you take what is yours and I'll take mine. Now let me at the truth which will refresh my broken mind. So tie me to a post and block my ears. I can see where those orphans threw my tears and know my cold despite my faults and despite my growth.
After a fair amount of descending, we're almost halfway. We're gonna have to start looking for places to kind of set up camp, get water, and eat. I think we have officially passed the Georgia border and now we're in Tennessee, so. So we figured out where we're gonna have our lunch. We set up camp here. There's a great waterfall right here, which is also perfect for filtering water and getting our water bottles back up. All right, so we're done eating. We got water. Bike chains are lubed, so we're good to go. No more noises. We're on the final stretch, sort of mentally. I think we're just about halfway
but you know, we're gonna start heading back towards the Georgia mountains and we should get pretty quicker from there. So
let's get it. We've been climbing for a good bit. Climbing and a lot of descending kind of intertwined. We're just leaving the Tennessee wilderness here. We should be going back into Georgia here shortly. And then we got one more big climb going up to Mountain Town. And then we really should be pretty close to the start again. How you doing, Daniel?
I'm doing great. Legs are in pain.
Yeah, a lot of climbing. I think there's like a total of 12,000 feet for this route. So there's a lot. And not only is it climbing, but it's pretty technical climbing too. All right, after what seemed to be like what?
It's day eight.
Day eight? That was a lot of climbing. We finally made it to the top where Mountain Town is, and it's pretty much descending from here on out.
Walking on your hands and see the world hanging upside down. You can understand dependence when you know their maker's land. So make your sirens call and sing all you want. My eyes, but I know you're good for it.